Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and today I'm coming to share with you those two books and this is more like a preview what you can expect in the future. This is not finished yet. I'm just editing tutorial for my Patreon with a wedding book and it's this one. It's wedding album and guest book and I just wanted to share with you because I shared with you that I do have my new tool, Brayer. And I use it in the previous videos. So I use that brayer again and I have created or painted my own abstract papers. Golden, a bit blue and a little bit of gray. And I have to say, I really did enjoy it. I do love that result of the painting with brayer. So I use that brayer for the background of my pages for guest book for wedding. And this is a very simple book. But I do love those colors and I use this style of sewing. It's very simple and it's so fast. And I created photo album, like wedding photo album. It's still in process of finishing. But I'm gonna give you a very fast look. There is not too many decorations yet and I'm not sure how much I will decorate it. I think I'm gonna put that just here and there. I just wanted to show you how beautifully can a photo album look with book pages. I'm gonna move this one a little bit there so you can see better way. So this is like wedding photo album. I'm not making it exactly like photo album, more like something between. Because I'm not sure how I will use it. I will probably sell it. I'm not sure yet. So I didn't make it exactly like photo album, but in the style. I just wanted to show how beautifully it can look with book pages. Because I think book pages are totally amazing decoration for not just for journals. So this is just like preview of what you can expect. This is not finished yet. It needs more things, especially on the cover. So right now I'm going to share with you those two books. I started to create this this journal. It shouldn't be that thick. It kind of went that way through the process and this mini book is going together with this journal. It's already sold. It's going together. This is made from leftovers. After I finished this journal, I had plenty of scraps and offcuts and I use them here and I think I'm gonna start to make something like this with every single of my projects because mostly I'm ending with so many offcuts and then I'm placing them on the side and I'm finishing with big chaos in my craft room. So I think I'm gonna make these mini books with so many of my scraps and offcuts. So this is the book I have created few months ago actually with my Patreons. I started from the scratch. I created this vintage looking book cover and then I painted. I actually hand painted these flowers and I'm so happy that I did it. I'm gonna open that book and show you a little bit more close. I hope nothing will fall out because there is really so many things. So this is my hand-painted book cover and I'm so happy of that result. I'm kind of proud of myself. You know, once you do just gluing papers, so there any kind of changes in your routine are perfect to do so. So I'm kind of proud of myself, of my painting. And maybe you see that here and there, that cover, it's like sparkling. That's because I started with white fabric on this cover, but I used a few layers of different colors, and in one color I have mixed glitters and it gives to my painting beautiful sparkle here and there. It's like always catching it here and there. It's like blink, blink like a star. So this is my handmade cover and I'm so happy how it turns out. I'm glad I made those labels here. For a closure, I have created this strip from the cardstock and layers of fabric and washi tape and those rings. And I'm using this clasp, I think it's called clasp, lobster clasp, clasps. Sorry, I don't remember exactly. I think it's clasp as a closure. So this book is kind of overloaded. I didn't meant to do it that way, that fat, that thick, but it somehow get that way. So here at the start we have foldable belly band, and it's, I'm gonna take some card. I'm gonna take the card, and it's like a belly band behind this opening, so something can be slide behind. And I made like layers. On that belly band on the top. I've got here a pocket, and here is another pocket. This is that string pocket. I'm not gonna open it because nothing is inside. It's ready to be used. I made few of these specimen windows. I stamped around and embossed that window, and it's holding with my handmade rusty paper clip. Here from the other side I made this cute layout, and I used my stamps and stencils and stickers. I do have those stickers on my Etsy, but this is a stamp. And this is from washi tape, actually. So here I do have a decorated Polaroid frame. I do have a few of them in this book. There is so many writing pages. Another that specimen window. So this journal has really so many writing pages. I did small layouts here and there. And here I would like to show you... not long time ago, I shared the technique with embossing powders, and I showed you on this. This is from embossing folder, and first I embossed the cardstock with this embossing folder. This is from Sizzix, Tim Holtz typewriter embossing folder. So in that video how you can use embossing powders, I showed you how I did this kind of rusty effect using embossing powder on embossed card. I'm so sorry, my explanation is very weird, but I hope to those who saw that video they will understand. And because I use that embossing folder with letters, I have created a few like alphabetical quotes. I do have them on my Patreon, but I will place them also on my Etsy for those who are interested to have it. And I'm using that embossed key snippet, maybe snippet, as a first decoration from that, you know, from that quote. So I do have quotes for each of those letters. Here I made just small layout from the other side. Ooh, I forgot to close this envelope, but I do have tutorial for this opening envelope on my YouTube. I've got here another dot specimen window. In that pocket behind, I do have this tag, and it's closing this way. It has also a pocket here. There is so many pockets in this folding envelope. It does have pocket here. I just can't get it there. Pocket here and pocket here. And it's closing with these strings. Like this. And here is same style of pocket. Behind that I do have this stamped, stamped folded image from this collection. This is again collection from Dreams etc. I had kind of so many of these papers print out, so I need to use them. Here another that specimen window. Here this is pocket where I used Tim Holtz papers, and I do have few pockets like this in this journal, so I'm gonna show you one and then I will just point it. So pocket using Tim Holtz papers. Here another pocket with another decorated Polaroid frame, and I really like this one. I mean, not just this one, I mean that idea to create Polaroid frames, decorate Polaroid frames. I think it's very cute. And we've got writing pages, small layout. Here I do have like pocket with tag and small stamped ephemera, and this is more for fun. This is my moving picture. So I did a small decoration using my stickers. I do have these stickers on my Etsy. I will put links down below for those who are interested. Here I do have another stamped image and again a sticker. I don't have yet photo stickers, but I think I will add them to my Etsy as well for those who would like to use them. There is nothing wrong with stickers, to use stickers. It's just, you know, paper ready to use. It's like when you are using, when you are printing out some images and then you are putting the glue to stick them somewhere. So here it's already with glue, that's sticker, that's the difference. Here I do have another that specimen window, and not long time ago I created those acetate bottles, and I was thinking I'm gonna use that acetate for more of my dies. So here I tried to that window. I cut out that. I do have this window for a long time, but I didn't use it because I'm planning to use it. And here I started. Probably I will go a little bit more far with decoration in the future. Definitely I will go a little bit more with decoration, but here I just wanted to try how it will looks like with that vintage look. So this is Sizzix, also Tim Holtz, Bix die. Here I do have just decoration and with wax, stamped wax, and it's like a pocket from here. I do have another that specimen window, writing pages. Here in this envelope I've got it's like vintage letter, looks like this. And when we flip it over, this is actually decorated paper clip. So from one side, it has this tag-like decoration. And I do have another decorated Polaroid frame. Here I do have opening like this, writing space. And it's pocket here on the top. And I do have there this mini tag. I did video with these mini tags a long time ago, and I think maybe 2 years ago, and I had with this also some freebies with this YouTube video. You will have to have a look, but it's a really long time ago when I created. And here I do have one of these slides, photo slides, so it can be like space for your picture. And I used this one. It's actually from a stamp. You know, stamps are always coming with that acetate sheet. So I use that sheet for my slides. Here's a small spread. And I have created another that decorated card or insert with another key. And it's holding with this rusty paper clip. Pages for writing, another that specimen window, again that Tim Holtz paper used on an envelope, writing pages. So this journal has so many writing pages. Here I do have another moving picture. Just need to grab it right away. So another moving picture, and here I used some stamping and some stickers to decorate it. So there is space for writing as well, or maybe for putting your own pictures on each of that side. And I do have tutorial for this book on my Patreon. And I do have also on my Patreon tutorial for the base of this book. Not decorating, but the base of that book. Here we do have envelope with small insert. It's like writing space. And another that slider. Photo slide. And from other side, I do have another this decorated tag with that embossed key. I think it's called key snippet, but I'm not sure about that. When it's just, you know, just this strip. Papers, another envelope, papers for writing. Here I do have another envelope with that photo slide. So it can be used like journaling space and maybe some picture here. And I think it will look very cute with with that stamped acetate. Here we've got another one used like as a pocket and Polaroid frame. And here I do have an envelope, nothing in there because I forgot. And here I do have another that belly band, that decorated belly band with those layouts. So something can be right in that on that belly band actually. And we have another that Polaroid frame, decorated Polaroid frame behind. Pages for writing. Another envelope here, another that large tag. There is so many writing space. Here I just laminated some images from this collection to create bookmark for this journal. And another writing space. Writing space. I try to decorate also, you know, those writing pages with leftovers to create some kind of interest on the edges of those papers. And here we've got another that decorated card. Here it's with a letter I. And here I do have small opening. Here is again that belly band. And when you open it, we've got pocket here. We've got opening here and plenty of space for writing. So it's like small mini folder. Here I do have another that moving picture and it's ready for to be decorated. Pocket, writing pages. Here I do have another piece decorated with that embossed effect. And here this plastic thingy, it's usually very long, like printed paper long, and it has open space here, and it's using for quick binding of papers. It's using mostly in office, where you will stack few papers inside of that open space, and it's really long. It can fit you know, A4 size paper. So I cut it on piece and I use that this plastic thingy to create my paper clip. And it's kind of fun. I had more of them, but I can't find them. After I tidy up my craft room, I can't find them. So I'm not sure where I placed those things. So writing space, another that writing belly band. I'm gonna call that writing belly band because it can be open. There is space for writing. This small layout, and it's like belly band, and it's holding another decorated Polaroid frame. Specimen window, papers for writing, another pocket, and this one, it's ready to be decorated for a new owner. Not sure if I said that, this journal, it's going together with this, it's already sold. And few more papers. I think here in the end, it's just few small decorations, another that decorated belly band with the Polaroid frame, and this small mini tag, and again this one, this large tag, specimen window, envelope, and few papers for writing. And I do have here my first folder. I've got here those another two, so now I'm gonna show you my mini folders I created for this book. And I didn't place them inside, all of them, because that book is really thick. So I created those two small mini folders, and they are both same, just decorated a little bit different way. I used dies and embossing folders, and I created these mini folders. They do have both pocket here, and I created their like collage tag. And both of them can be open, and it has a small pocket here, maybe space for some picture, for some photography, and writing space here. And this second one is same, it has pocket here with collage tag, and it can be open, pocket here, space maybe for picture here, and writing space on the back. Pardon me. And then I created this large one, a large tuck or a mini folder. So it's holding with this string. I created this collage using all kind of ephemeras and vintage pictures. I did create it also, you know, that semi-transparent, the photo, and it can be opened this way, and it has pocket here, writing space here, and it can be also open this way, and it has a large space for writing here. So this is my mini folder, and I think I was already on the end of that journal. There wasn't too many to see. Yeah, I was already on the end of that journal, so I'm gonna move to this mini folder or rolling book. I had so many offcuts from creating that book, and I decided to use it somehow. Do not do my tradition that I will put it to the piler and move it on the side. No, I don't wanna do it anymore. So I decided to do something cute. This is not journal, it's more like a visual book, I guess, because there is no space for writing, maybe a very small one. So I do have pocket behind, and in that pocket I've got this beautiful photography, and from one large tag, which is with that collection I used, that from Dreams etc., that widget collection, there is tag like this, and I created this small mini envelope. So it's in this pocket, and here we've got my rolling book. So I used so many different styles of embossing folders and stamps, and you will see. And here another tag made like writing space, and it's again from that collection. One tag I just folded to create this mini book, and it's in the pocket here. When I roll it down, I do have one pocket here and another pocket here, and I used again embossing embossing folders. I'm so sorry, I had to sip a little bit of water, my throat get dry, and I was very close to that cough, like very hot. So we do have two pockets here, and I've got that this beautiful picture, this kind of collage tag, or writing space, and here this index card, and it's a washi tape and some stamping all around. So it's here, And I'm gonna roll it down, and here we have this opening. I've got pocket here, belly band here, and I used again that quote, like alphabet quote. I used again that embossed thingy. I've got belly band here for another this mini tuck or mini tuck. I'm gonna call that mini tuck. Here I've got small booklet for writing. It's in the pocket here. And here I do have, yeah, see that, so there is small space for writing. I do have mini layout here and the pocket behind, and with small space for writing, right? So there is some space for writing. It's here. And from this side we do have it's like ID window, this one. I'm gonna call that ID window because you can actually put there something. And I do have another pocket from here, so you can slide something behind here. And I used some stamping to decorate it. I was actually totally inspired by Marley Design to create all that stamping all around, because I just loved her layering of stamps. So this I created inspired by her. And here I do have another rolling over, and I do have opening here and opening here, space maybe for photography or maybe for writing. I do have that specimen window here. Here I do have small pocket, but I don't have anything in there. But I do have another pocket here, and we've got another writing space and mini booklet or mini insert. And here this is more for feeling the embossed effect and you know, those colors and coloring and embossing and stamping. So this is really more like a visual book. And I do have small pocket here, so something can be slide in there. And in the last pocket in the row here, I had this picture, and it's all sewn around. And when I flip it over, I do have kind of last opening this way. So here is another embossed effect and some decoration stickers. This is from Tim Holtz collection of those in the back. It's from that ideology. Oh my, maybe I'm saying that wrong, but it's from Tim Holtz, this one. And I do have pocket here, some stamping and washi tapes, and here I do have those two small inserts. They are like writing space, right? So here you can see what I have created using all those leftovers. Here there was like very small strips, you know, but with beautiful design, so I had to use it. So there is not like big sheets, but mostly strips. And here I do have a last picture, which I add to this beautiful mini book. So this is my mini rolling book I created using my leftovers and offcuts. Here you can see another leftover that was really strip like this, but because there was those numbers, I wanted to use it somehow. And this is here we've got another leftover from that collection. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you found some inspiration, hopefully. I hope you did enjoy it. Thank you so, so much for visiting me today. Thank you so much for spending your time with me. Have a beautiful day. Take care about yourself, and I will see you soon. Bye.